Dear friends of the Tom Photo channel and all new viewers, I just produced a video on HD versus 4K video quality with the intent to produce the best HD videos. The link is below. Today's video is a logical continuation in a way. I'd like to systematically see how the main video rendering quality setting affects the video that is being output. I'm going to evaluate the output video numerically rather than just eyeball it, so that I could make better conclusions. I'm going to use Kdenlive version 21.12.3 to do the video renderings, but this doesn't matter because the general results will apply to your favorite video editor as well. The video quality setting for rendering video is a mysterious parameter. Just this one parameter determines your video quality. Lower numbers mean higher quality because less megabits per second are packed. A typical excellent value is 20, a good default to save some disk space is 23. But what if you go much higher or lower? What does this do to the video quality and file size? Let's examine systematically. I'm going to shoot a 4K video and an HD video of both static objects and moving objects. Then I'm going to render all these four videos with many video quality settings. I will evaluate the outcomes by extracting individual frames from the video and measuring their sharpness and overall image quality. I use special Python scripts that I've modified myself, and I've talked about both of them before, please see the links below. I also determine all file sizes and bitrates for all versions of video produced. The HD video was rendered using the H.264 codec and the 4K video using the H.265 codec. I filmed a small pine tree by the wall using 4K at 200 megabits per second and HD at 50 megabits per second. This ensures that we have the same number of megabits recorded for each pixel in both videos. You see the 4K video is exactly 4 times the size of HD video in pixels. The megabits per second value indicates how much information you can pack into the file for each second of video. I made 2 versions of videos. All were 2 seconds long for both 4K and HD. With the tree still and with the tree being shaken. Yes, believe it or not, but I tied a rope to the tree and shook it while filming. So now we have 4K with static tree and shaking tree, and we have HD with static tree and shaking tree. We need both still and moving object videos because this matters, as you'll soon see. All parameters were fixed in all 4 videos. I filmed from a stable tripod at 30 frames per second using Provia film simulation and dynamic range 100%. White balance was fixed, the shutter speed was 60, f-stop was 8 and ISO was 800. I focused only once before filming and then set the focus to manual to make sure it won't move. Let's get to the results. First, the image sharpness. You'll always see the same color coding in all of my graphs as here. Blue is 4K with shaking, red is HD with shaking, orange is 4K still, and green is HD still. The x-axis is always image quality, decreasing from left to right. In this case, the y-axis is image sharpness. For the first graph, I divided all sharpness values by the first value of its corresponding series. This makes the first value equal to 1 and we can better compare the trends. You cannot conclude it from here, but still videos always had better sharpness than those with moving objects as expected. Here we see that the still video lines start to curve down later than those of the shaking ones. Also, the 4K video lines start going down sooner than the HD ones. So 4K and moving objects call for higher rendering quality. If we now additionally force the end of each line to be a zero, we get this graph. Now the sharpness graph must fit between 0 and 1. First, we see that the still object HD line goes up and down. Interesting. It has a maximum at quality setting 23, which coincidentally is the default video quality rendering setting for many video editors. I think we just discovered why this is the case. The 4K video with shaking shows a straight line. So if you have a large format video with moving objects, every step in the direction of making the video quality setting better will make your video better in a linear fashion. This is not so true for HD and calm videos. Next up is overall image quality. This is the already familiar figure where all quality values were divided by the first one to bring the beginnings of graphs to one. The still videos still hold their quality better than the ones with shaking. Compared to the sharpness graph, the HD and 4K videos have traded their places. The 4K videos hold their overall quality relatively better when making the video rendering parameter worse, or increasing its number. Let's also force the values between 0 and 1. And we see two groups. Top is the videos of still objects, and the bottom is the videos of moving objects. The still ones hold their quality longer, but then break and start to degrade even faster. This is seemingly so, probably because the shaking tree already looks a bit degraded to the quality measuring algorithm. Interestingly, the 4K and HD behave very similarly here, which is in contrast to the image sharpness graphs we saw before. Anyway, these graphs don't give us very good recommendations as to what setting is optimal to use. But what about the simple metric of file size? This matters because large files are difficult to store. 4K videos are larger, but the videos of shaking objects are also larger than those of still objects. With lowering the rendering quality, the 4K file size drops faster than the HD file size. Something to consider when wanting to conserve disk space. By the way, look at the huge difference in file size between still tree in HD and moving tree in 4K. Let's also look at bitrate, megabits per second. Remember, we gave the 4K video 200 megabits per second and the HD video 50 megabits per second to use as the maximal value. This graph has almost exactly the same shape as that of the file size. This was expected too. None of the videos filled up the information density container as we can see, so this was not limiting. The 4K doesn't go anywhere near 200 and the best HD stops short of 50. The HD was certainly closer to information saturation than the 4K was. But what happens if we divide file size in megabytes by bitrate in megabits per second? Then we see how much bang we get for each unit of file storage, if you will. The lines are almost flat. They don't seem flat here because I zoomed in a lot. Upon closer inspection, we see something interesting here though. The still HD video has maximum value again at 23, as we saw with image sharpness. The still 4K also doesn't look bad at all at the value of 23. The videos with shaking don't give us good answers. So it's time for filtering out the take-home messages. First, the lower the video quality value when rendering, the better your video. And obviously, the larger the file size. Throughout all experiments, I could never visually detect large differences in video quality when the video was playing. Even when extracting the frames and expecting them frame by frame, I did not see justifiable differences. My suggestion, based on the graphs, is that the quality setting of 23 indeed seems to be the magical value for HD, especially when the scene is calm. The 23 is also the best optimal choice for saving disk space. Things are not so clear with 4K. Based on my graphs, I'd lean toward using smaller values, but on most occasions no lower than 20. This will create large files. So if the file size is too large, then 23 will also work for 4K. However, If you have a lot of moving objects, such as treetops in the wind, going back to 20 is safer. In the end, it boils down to what your eyes perceive and what the screen is and the overall system is that you use to watch the video. I'm mostly using 23 for HD and 20 for 4K when disk space is not an issue. I hope you found my video interesting. If yes, please consider subscribing to my channel. Please also check out my past and future videos. Have a great day.